Welcome back to the South Bristol Chess Club Club Championship 2013. We're going to take a look at the second game in Group B now between Dan Travis and Tyson Mordew. This is going to be an interesting game indeed as wildcard Travis goes up against one of the favourites for the tournament, Mordew. What do we know about Dan Travis? Well, this young man joined the chess club and has really gained a strong reputation in his very first year. He plays attacking, fearless chess and is full of confidence. He faces Tyson Mordew, who is one of the strongest chess players in Bristol and has been for many years now. This FIDE master once defeated a grandmaster, so Travis has really got his work cut out here. But he appears to be afraid of no one. Let's see how the game pans out. I'm really looking forward to this one.
Right, it's my first club championship at South Bristol. It's a Group B game against Tyson Mordew. Very much looking forward to this. He's obviously a very, very strong player. Probably the most, probably the best player I've ever played against. I'm going to play an opening I know reasonably well. I'm going to start with e4.
Okay, I'm playing Dan Travis, the new sensation in the C team. Got to keep my wits about me here because I never know what might happen. He's opened up with e4, and I always play the Sicilian defence, so c5.
Right, he's played c5. I've played once against Tyson Mordew before, and this is what he played, the Sicilian. He obviously knows this game very, very well. He beat me very quickly with this opening last time. I'm going to have to respond with knight f3, but I will have to try and change it up if I can a bit later on, but for now, knight f3.
Okay, he's played two knight f3, which is straightforward enough. I never know against this sort of player whether they're going to play bishop c4, c3, knight c3, anything to delay d4. So it might be some sort of semi-close system. So I want to be able to play a d5 in one move. So I'm not going to play the normal d6. I'm going to play e6. We'll probably get into escape an engine, but I'm quite happy with that. So to e6.
E6, this is exactly what he played against me last time in a friendly. There's only one move, d4.
Not much to think about here. C takes d4.
C takes on d4, only one move. Knight takes on d4.
Normal move here is knight f6. He's taking quite a while over this move. I'm wondering why. Normal moves knight c3. Bishop d3 is a move. Maybe he's thinking about f3, which I've had before, in which case I can just play d5 quite readily. If he goes e5, knight fd7, it's a sort of French, which is perfectly okay for me. I'm quite comfortable with that. But he really is taking just a little bit too long for move 5 in a 30-move game.
Tyson's played knight f6. I was expecting that. So the normal done thing here is knight c3. I know what he's going to play against that, so I'm reluctant to play the usual lines here. I could also consider f3. I'm taking a long time making this decision. I'm very keen on mixing it up. I'm very keen on playing something that he doesn't recognize, just to get him to spend a bit more time on his moves. I'm going to try something a little bit wild. Oh, the hell with it. Let's just do it. Bishop g5.
Okay, now that's an odd sort of move. Now, if he played e5, that just loses a pawn to queen a5 check. had that before, but this is a little bit peculiar because I can play queen a5 check anyway, and he's got a little problem, because if he puts things in the way like the knight, I can just play knight takes e4 because I've broken the pin on the f6 knight. If he plays queen to d2, I've got bishop b4, and then I can go and take on e4 regardless of what he puts in the way. For example, c3, knight takes e4, c takes b4, queen takes g5 because it's defended by the knight on e4. That's perfectly good for me. If he plays bishop d2, I've got queen b6. I'm attacking three things simultaneously. So queen a5 check. Ooh, he looks a little discomforted by that.
Oh no, that is a big blunder. Well, if anybody can exploit a blunder, it will be Tyson. I think the game's over. I'm not sure whether I should resign on the spot or whether I should carry on. I think since it is my first club championship, I'm going to try and carry on. And there's only virtually one move anyway. Bishop d2.
Okay, bishop d2, virtually on your move. Now I can play queen b6, and I'm hitting the pawn on b2, and the knight on d4 with the queen, and also I'm threatening knight takes e4, so he's already losing some material here.
Queen back to b6. Well, that's a very strong move. He's hitting the knight and the pawn at the same time. I've got to find a way of protecting both of them. At the same time, he's threatening my e4 pawn. I think this is dead. I should probably resign. I can see two moves. Bishop c3 or knight b3. None of them protect the e4 pawn. I think I'm pretty much doomed. I gotta play something. Knight b3.
Okay, well, he screened the b pawn by moving the knight, but I can just take on e4, and I'm hitting the bishop, and I'm just a pawn up with a very good game. Might even end up getting the two bishops. Oh, he's playing that one a bit quick.
Knight takes on e4. I can't believe I've got myself into this position within about seven moves. I think the position is totally lost. I'm going to have to develop some of my pieces. I need to get my knight out of this b1 square. My bishop isn't developed. I can't castle. I'm in a lot of trouble here, but I'm just going to move. Knight c3.
Queen takes f2, mate. Didn't even think about it.
Oh my word! A travesty for Dan Travis, as he's checkmated within 10 moves. Poor old Dan, the wildcard entry to this group, knows that he could have done better there, and we know it too. But sometimes that does happen. It looks like perhaps the nerves and the pressure got to him. He'll be looking to do better in his next game. But for Tyson Mordew, it's a great start, a tasty morsel of a win, and that puts him on 1 point and in a good position. Next time, we'll be looking at the second game in this group, Group B, of Round 1, between Richard Garrett and Jerry Jeps. See you again soon.